Untitled poem number 5. My Lord, my only constant, shown and proved. Shimmering radiance upon me, inside my very being. Not one to smother or trap, not a game or a burn, but a completeness. So fine and yet so full, the yearning and craving begins and ends with you. You bring me joy unspeakable, eternal bliss, contentment, words will not do when I'm really truly in your presence. Devoid of distractions or guilt, all the days of my life is this feeling of fullness when I run to you. Untitled poem number 6. Reaping anger and frustrations at what I had done. Consequences that will last a lifetime. People say that this testing will mold me into your image, yet my carnal self cannot see the vision you attempt to present me, needing you more and more. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Not only with prosperity, but with power, grace, and strength. Discipleship. You are the one who showed me my sin, not with a finger pointed, no blame assigned, but still you call me home, no turning away time after time, not wanting to bear my cross, though I know the price has been paid, death gone forever, pain gone, left at your altar, and yet I find myself sinking in a storm, because of my eyes fall off of you. At times, the clarity can be so intense at times. The blood purifies all the accusations of internal strife, breaking barriers. Sometimes slow, the heat of your calling soothes my ears, blocking the accusations spread across my mind for past lies, for past failures, for stupid mistakes. My only hope pierces the air with cries of thanksgivings. You to answer selfish prayers to consume upon our own desires, not truly asking your will be done, not sharing your joy, what our wants instead. Though you have always provided our needs of food and raiment, as eternal love shines in all its glory upon our bodies, we still ask for the things of Demas. Seek ye first. Let me run toward you, fast and furious, as I did before, on that day I was afraid, scared, alone, not wanting anything corruptible that rusts or molds or falls apart, but your peace within me, needing your joy much more than ever did before. Pleasures pass, seasons move, shifting patterns of ups and downs, my spirit strives for you. Even when shifting loyalties play tug of war, raging against and within the eternal fight of good, evil, self, making power plays. Who will win is all up to whom I give heed to. When I forget, the sweat and tears are unnecessary weights on my back. When I forget to give them to him, holding my cross becomes unbearable when I forget the destination. The better country becomes a mere pipe dream of a never, never land when I forget the streets of gold and gates of fine pearl, when I will reside in riots of righteousness, laughter, songs of joyous feasts. Untitled poem number 7. You are so good to me, though I doubt at times, revealing to me that you are there, where no one around has faith point fingers with no defenses up, not guarding my heart, the same heart that changed, a fresh start to grow up clean. I love you, Christ, tell all that you saved me from hell and my own self. The pride grew too steep, the sulfur pit sunk further deep. But you heard the cries of despair, the lonely nights of silent tears, moaning at empty voids, trying to fill a dark filled soul. The light and power of your holiness expose the darkness of what it is. I will not set wicked things before mine eyes.